Hello video creators, thanks for watching StoryHume. Today we've got a short and simple Premiere Pro tutorial on the menu. In this one we're going to add a fake stop motion effect to our footage. To achieve the real stop motion effect you need to shoot a lot of photos, then adjust the scene between the shots and then stitch them together in post. So it could take hours to shoot a short video, but the results can be amazing. I really admire some of the very creative and patient people that take this a step further by making an entire film with this technique. I'm definitely not that patient, so that is why I'm going to fake this effect and I'm going to add a stop motion look to my clips. Sure, this won't look as good as actual stop motion, but still you can get some cool results. And you could also use this same effect to create an old school, vintage 1920s look, which I'll show you later on in the video. But for now, I will start with the basics inside Premiere Pro. Inside Premiere, I've already imported a clip into the project panel. First, we'll need to create a new sequence. Right-click on the video file and then select New Sequence from Clip. This will create a new sequence based on the settings of the video clip. If I give this a playback, you'll see that the clip is played in real time. And if I pause the video, you will see that there's almost no motion blur. And that's exactly what we want, because this effect will work better if you use a clip that was recorded with a higher shutter speed. It just won't work as well if you have a clip with a lot of motion blur, so try to avoid that. Okay, back in Premiere, we're going to add an effect and this will give us the stop motion look. In the effects panel, we're going to search for the posterize time effect. You'll find this one under video effects time. I'll select this effect, then drag it over to the timeline and apply this to the video clip. And then move over to the effect controls panel and you'll find the effect here. The posterize time effect will give you the option to lower the number of frames per second. It all depends on the type of content, but if you want to create this stop motion look, then you should go for something between 2 and 8 frames. So for the example clip, I'll start with 3 frames per second and that looks like this. And here you can see the difference between 3 and 8 frames per second. Sometimes it also works better if you slow down the footage. This is speed at 100% with 4 frames per second. And this is how it looks on a third of the speed with 2 frames per second. In Premiere, you can slow down or speed up a clip if you right-click on them and then select Speed and Duration. And then in the window that opens up, you can enter a percentage for the speed of the clip. And for this video, we're going to slow it down to a third of the speed. And then I'll apply the posterize time effect and then set it to 2 frames per second. And again, this is how it looks on a third of the speed with 2 frames per second. As I promised in the beginning of this video, I will also use the posterize time effect to create an old school film look from the 1920s. Let's take this clip for example. We'll add the posterize time effect and then change the frame rate to 4 frames per second. And now this same clip looks like this. Next, I will head over to the Lumetri color panel and then open up the Creative tab. And in there, I'm going to increase the faded film look and decrease vibrance and saturation. And if you like, you can also add a bit of vignette. Something like this should work for most clips. And as a bonus, you could also add an old film look overlay. Here, I've got a couple of overlays from Envato Elements, but you can probably also find free alternatives on sites like Videvo and Pixabay. I'll add some links in the description so you can check them out. Now I will simply drag the overlay video over to the timeline, and then go into the opacity section in the effect controls panel, and then set blend mode to screen and then lower the opacity. And this all together creates a nice old school 20s film look. And that's it for this short stop motion look tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it and if you did, then please like the video, that really helps a lot. If you want to see how real stop motion movies are animated in a studio, then check this cool video by Insider. Anyway, as always, thanks a lot for watching and I hope you have a wonderful day.